Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen that how the MOSFET can be used as a common source amplifier. And in that configuration, the MOSFET was biased in the voltage divider biasing configuration. Similarly, another important biasing technique is the drain feedback bias. So in this video, we will do the small signal analysis of the common source amplifier whenever it is biased using the drain feedback bias. And we will also find the expression of the voltage gain, the input and the output impedance. And at the later part of the video, I will also show you some simulation results. So for the small signal analysis, we will follow the same procedure. That means first consider all the DC sources in the circuit as zero, and then replace all the coupling and the bypass capacitors by the short circuit. And then after, replace the MOSFET by the small signal model. So here if you observe, the input is appearing between the gate and the source terminal. And here, the source terminal is grounded. While if you see this feedback resistor, then it is appearing between the drain and the ground terminal. And this drain resistor RD is appearing between the drain and the ground terminal. Or effectively we can say that it is appearing between the drain and the source terminal. So if you see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. So now, let us find the input impedance, output impedance and the voltage gain of this configuration. And first of all, let us find the input impedance. So if II is the input current and the VI is the input signal, then the ratio of this VI and the II will give us the input impedance. So here, the current through this feedback resistor is equal to II. And if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can write this current II is equal to ID plus Vout divided by RD. That means II is equal to GM times VGS plus Vout divided by RD. And here this VGS is equal to input signal, right? That means current II is equal to GM times VI plus Vout divided by RD. And if we further simplify it, then we can say that this Vout is equal to II minus GM times VI times RD. Let's say this is the expression number 1. Now here, the voltage at this node is equal to Vout. That means current II can be given as Vin minus Vout divided by RF. Or we can say that this Vout is equal to Vin minus this II times RF. Let's call this expression as the expression number 2. So if we compare these two expressions, then we can write Vi minus II times RF, that is equal to II times RD minus GM times VI times RD. Or we can say that this VI times 1 plus GM times RD, that is equal to II times RD plus RF. That means VI divided by II, or the input impedance, is equal to RD plus RF divided by 1 plus GM times RD. Now typically, this feedback resistor RF is much greater than RD. So approximately we can say that this input impedance is equal to RF divided by 1 plus GM times RD. So in this way, we got the expression of the input impedance. So similarly, now let us find the output impedance. So the output impedance is the Thevenin's equivalent impedance which is seen from the output side. And to find that, we will consider all the independent sources in the circuit as zero. That means while finding the output impedance, this input voltage source will act as a short circuit. And because of that, this VGS will also become 0. Now once the VGS is equal to 0, then this dependent current source will also become zero and it will act as a open circuit. So now if you see, then the equivalent resistance which is seen from the output side is the parallel combination of this RF and the RD. That means output impedance or Z out is equal to RD parallel RF. So this is the expression of the output impedance. And similarly, now let us find the voltage gain. So as we have just seen, the current through the feedback resistor is equal to II. And if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can write this current II is equal to GM times VGS plus Vout divided by RD, or current II is equal to GM times VI plus Vout divided by RD. And this current II can also be given as VI minus Vout divided by RF. So if we equate these two expressions, then we can write VI minus Vout divided by RF, that is equal to GM times VI plus Vout divided by RD. That means VI times 1 divided by RF minus GM is equal to Vout times 1 over RF plus 1 divided by RD. That means the voltage gain, that is Vout divided by Vin, is equal to 1 divided by RF minus GM divided by 1 divided by RF plus 1 divided by RD. Now typically, since this RF is in mega ohm, so this 1 over RF is much less than GM. So approximately we can say that this voltage gain is equal to minus GM divided by 1 divided by RF plus 1 divided by RD. Now this 1 divided by 1 over RF plus 1 over RD is equal to RF parallel RD, right? That means we can say that this voltage gain is approximately equal to minus GM times RD parallel RF. And since this RF is much greater than RD, so again we can say that this voltage gain is approximately equal to minus GM times RD. So this is the expression of the voltage gain. So in this way, we found the expression of the input impedance, the output impedance and the voltage gain. Now so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the output resistance of the MOSFET is infinite. But if we also consider the effect of the output resistance, then now instead of this resistor RD, now we need to consider the parallel combination of this RD and the R0. That means in the all above expressions, instead of resistor RD, there will be a RD parallel R0. So these are the expression of the input impedance, the output impedance and the voltage gain of this amplifier with considering the effect of the output resistance. Alright, so now let us take one example based on this configuration so that it will get clear to you. So here, for the given amplifier configuration, we have been asked to find the input impedance, the output impedance and the voltage gain. Now all these parameters can be found using the small signal analysis. But for that, we need to know the transconductance of this MOSFET at the operating point. And that can be found using the DC analysis. So when the MOSFET is operating in the saturation region, then this drain current ID can be given as K times VGS minus VT whole square, where this K depends on the device parameters. And if we see the exact expression, then it is equal to half times mu n times COx times W divided by L times VGS minus VT whole square. Now here, since the device parameters are not given, so we cannot use this second expression. But instead of that, here we have been given the value of the VGS on and the ID on. So using that, we can find the value of this K. So here, this K is equal to ID on divided by VGS on minus Vt whole square. So here this ID on is equal to 6 milliampere, while this VGS on is equal to 8 volt. So in the denominator, there will be a 8 minus 3 whole square. That means the value of K is equal to 0.24 times 10 to the power minus 3 ampere per volt square. So once we know the value of the K, then using that, we can find the VGS. So for this drain feedback bias, the voltage VGS is equal to VDS, and it will be equal to 12 minus ID times RD. And in the saturation, this drain current ID is equal to K times VGS minus VT whole square. So let us put the value of VGS in second expression. That means drain current ID is equal to 0.24 times 10 to the power minus 3 times 12 minus ID times RD minus 3 whole square. So if we further simplify it, then we can write 4166.6 times ID, that is equal to 9 minus ID times RD whole square, where this RD is equal to 2 kilo ohm. So if we further simplify this expression, then we can write 4166.6 times ID, that is equal to 81 minus 36,000 ID plus 4 times 10 to the power 6 times ID square. Or we can say that 4 times 10 to the power 6 times ID square minus 40166.6 times ID plus 81, that is equal to 0. So if we solve this quadratic equation, then we will get the two roots of the drain current. One is this 7.24 milliampere, while the second one is 2.794 milliampere. Now with the first value of the drain current, the VGS will be negative. That means that can't be the value of the drain current. And therefore, this drain current is equal to 2.794 milliampere. So with that value of the drain current, the voltage VGS is equal to 12 minus ID times RD. That is equal to 12 minus 2.794 milliampere times 2 kilo. That is equal to 6.412 volt. And if you are aware, then this transconductance GM is equal to 2 times K times VGS minus VT. That means at the operating point, the transconductance is equal to 2 times 0.24 times 10 to the power minus 3 times 6.412 minus 3. That is equal to 1.637 millisiemens. So in this way, we found the value of the transconductance. And once we know the value of the transconductance, then using the small signal analysis, we can easily find the required parameters. So for the small signal analysis, all the DC sources in the circuit will act as a zero, and all the coupling and the bypass capacitors can be replaced by the short circuit. And then after, if we replace the MOSFET by the small signal model, then the equivalent circuit will look like this. So as we have seen, here the input impedance is equal to RF divided by 1 plus GM times RD. That means here the input impedance is equal to 10 mega ohm divided by 1 plus 1.637 times 2, which is roughly equal to 2.339 mega ohm. So this is the approximate value of the input impedance. Similarly, the output impedance is the parallel combination of this RF and the RD. That means it is equal to 2 kilo ohm in parallel with 10 mega ohm, which is roughly equal to 2 kilo ohm. That means the output impedance of this amplifier configuration is equal to 2 kilo ohm. And similarly, the voltage gain, that is Vout divided by Vin, is approximately equal to minus Gm times Rd. That is equal to minus 1.637 times 2. That is equal to minus 3.274. So this is the approximate gain of this amplifier. So now for the same circuit, let me also show you some simulation results so that it will get more clear to you. So the same circuit which we have discussed in the example is built over here. And to get the similar results, the only thing which we need to set over here is the MOSFET parameters. So here, this threshold voltage is set to 3 volt, and to get the value of K is equal to 0.24 milliampere per volt square, the W by L ratio is kept 1. But here, this process transconductance or the mu n times COX is kept 0.48 milliampere per volt square, so that we get the value of K as 0.24 milliampere per volt square. And as you can see, here the channel length modulation parameter lambda is kept 0. That means the output resistance of the MOSFET is equal to infinite. So after setting these MOSFET parameters, a 1 millivolt of input signal is applied at the input side. And to just measure the output, a very large value of resistance is connected as a load. So in the small signal model, this RL will come in parallel with the RD. And when this RL is very large, then it will not have any impact on the voltage gain. Alright, so now let me just run this simulation and let me show you some output results. So here, this blue waveform, which is varying between the plus minus 1 millivolt, is the input signal. And this green signal is the output signal. And if you observe over here, then there is a 180 degree phase shift between the input and the output signal. Also, if you see this output signal, then it is varying between 3.2 to minus 3.2 millivolt. That means approximately the gain of this amplifier is equal to minus 3.26, and it is very close to our calculated value. So in this way, we can design this common source amplifier which is configured in the drain feedback bias configuration. So I hope in this video you understood how to do a small signal analysis of this common source amplifier whenever it is biased in the drain feedback bias configuration. And hopefully, this solved example and this simulation will also help you in understanding this configuration. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.